Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. And today in this video I'm going to show you how you can stabilize your footage inside Nuke, just like we are doing in Adobe After Effects and Premiere Pro using the warp stabilizer. So let's see how this can be possible inside Nuke. Let's quickly talk about the stabilization options, what we have in before jumping into the actual setup, which is doing exactly the same as the After Effects and Premiere Pro warp stabilizer. In Nuke, we have two methods to do the stabilization using the 2D tracker and the camera tracker. These tools are mainly for, you know, tracking and stabilizing a specific point, not to stabilize the entire footage. We have to know where to use this corner pin, transform and the tracker node. Also the camera tracker, we can project something and we can stabilize. So it's a whole different idea, and the purpose of doing stabilization and match move in camera tracker and the 2D tracker is totally different use. What we actually need, we need to stabilize the entire footage, just like the warp stabilization. In the past I use After Effects a lot, so inside we have that Adobe warp stabilizer, which is working very good when you have a very shaky footage, and it's great sometimes artifact, but most of the time it get the job done. What you need, a subtle stabilization on your footage, or if you have a very shaky footage, that will also work, but sometimes, as I said, it's creating some other artifacts, some warping, and all those things are, you can see directly, you can, it's all those things are visible. But how to achieve that similar look inside Nuke? I got this question many times, and we should have an alternate tool just like the warp stabilization, and fortunately we have a tool, and that tool is called the F-Steady. This is this tool F-Steady, and it's very underrated. Many people don't know about this tool, but this is, if you right click in the menu and if you go in the in this core, you can see there are many tools, and previously I was use this tool, what we call F regrain. So you can see on my screen, so this is the F regrain tool which we are using previously when we don't have the dark grain. It also have a deflicker and align and rig removal and wire removal also. So many people know this tool, but they don't know about this F steadiness. So I will show you how to use this one, and it's very good. So in the bottom I will show you, I have a couple of examples here which I already did the stabilization on them, but I will do it from scratch and I want to show you the whole idea. So let's take the new one. Let me just connect this one and first see this footage. So all these footages are from Action VFX, so you guys can download from there, and you can see this is very shaky footage. So this type of footage, if you put in warp stabilization in Adobe, it will do pretty good job to stabilize the hand shakiness, you can see. So let's try with the F steadiness. Let's add the tool first, and once you add, you can see this is the interface, the properties panel, and in the viewer you can see it's saying no valid keyframe analyze found, please press analyze. So we need to do that analyze first, and then you can see that all the settings. In the viewer you can see we have this big box, so this is basically the search area. So if you hover over, it will show you drag this box around the steady area to share by the all frame. So I'm just placing this box covering that entire footage, and then there are some, you know, properties here what you want to include. So currently in this one I'm just including rotation and translation. There is a perspective, but you just have to experiment with these settings. Sometimes they are giving you a good result, sometimes they're not. And let's first analyze this one, and I already have a clip, so it's a clip, source clip, and let's analyze. So you can see it's analyzing the plate, and it will go through all the frame just like the camera tracker, and it will analyze, and you can see in the preview it's tracking the whole frame, and this is basically it's calculating the shakiness. You can see when it's moving, you can see the borders, so it's calculating the shakiness, and when it's done it will give you the stabilization using the corner pin. Alright, so you can see the analyze is done, and the frame is 346, so it's pretty long shot, and let's play quickly and see the default result what you get from this tool. First of all, you can see it's pretty zoom in, and second thing, it's pretty steady, as you can see, but in the initial it's giving you this jump, I guess. Yeah, you can see, because this guy is coming out of the frame, and you can see, so that's why for this frame we are not gonna get that much good result. Other than that, you can see the whole shot is now pretty steady instead of this except the scaling issue. So we are going to see how to solve that scaling issue, but it's doing pretty good job. So you can use this tool to do a stabilization. So let's fix the scaling issue. So if you go to the properties panel, if you open this advanced tab and let's scroll down, you can see we have many more options. So let's ignore this analyze because you already saw that. And let's open this corner pin. So basically it's doing a corner pinning. You can see these are the corner pin, and you can see that overscan because it's a scale, because it's doing a scaling to our footage through the stabilization and the corner pinning also. So this is the output. You can copy paste this in your corner pin. You can take a corner pin here, and you can just copy paste all the animation keyframe animation without the scaling. But instead of doing this, what you can do is there is feature called this auto scale. This is basically doing that scaling thing. So if I reduce this amount, you can see we are reducing the scale. If you put zero, so we are getting back to our original plate, but we're getting the black bar here, because obviously we will get, because we don't have the extra pixel to do the stabilization. So it's basically moving the entire frame to, you know, remove the shakiness. To compensate that, we need to do some scaling. So for the scaling, you can use this, or you can add a transform, just like I added here another transform. So let's first see that footage, and you can see it's pretty steady. You can see, except the edges are, you know, floating around, because we need to scale up the plate a bit to hide the edges. If you ignore the edges, the overall is pretty good. It's doing a pretty good stabilization in my opinion. So in this one, you can see it's doing pretty nice job. So I like this one. So let's fix the scaling, and let me increase the scaling here. You can increase, let's see the 0.2, and did we get any black pixel? So we can see, we can increase this bit more, like 0.3. We can adjust how much scaling we want. Default is 1 is too much, so we can reduce this amount. So I will put it 0.5 and I will hit OK, and let's see how it will look. In my opinion, this is enough, and let's compare with this one. So obviously we'll get this much of scale. I think this is too much of scale, or we can animate the scale if you want. So there are many possibilities we can do with this tool. So in here, what I did, I set it the scaling to 0, and I use a transform node to add a scaling. And how much I add? 1.2. So I'm just adding a 0.2 scaling, and this is my footage. This is looking pretty good. So let me show you another example. So this is another footage from Action VFX, and you can see the camera shakiness. See how the steady tool help us. And if I play this shot, you can see this is also looking pretty good in terms of removing the camera shake. So the shakiness is removed, but we are getting the black edge. So that's why I added a transform, and I scale up this footage a bit. So 1.1, and now you can see it's pretty good stabilization. See the environment too, is going pretty smooth. In the steadiness, we have a couple of options here. We can do a smoothness, or we can do absolute lock, but I found the smoothness is enough for us to do the stabilization. If you want to do a lock-on mode, you can obviously use the camera tracker and do a single point track, and you can just stabilize that way instead of using this tool. This tool is, you can use to stabilize the entire footage. And here the another example, same thing. Let's see the plate first. So this much of camera shake we have in this plate, and obviously you have to consider the lens flare, the see how much light we are getting here. And this tool is pretty good. If I view from here, you can see it's considering everything, and we are not getting any jerkiness or any artifact in this area. It's playing pretty nicely, and that's why I like this one. In this one, I set it the auto scale 1 because it's not doing that much of scaling, but it's giving me pretty good result. You can see how smooth this is going. So definitely give it a try. It's pretty good tool, and it's doing, sometimes it's giving some weird result, but you just need to play around with the setting. There are much more setting here. And one more thing I want to show you how you can use this tool. I let this finish. You can see how good stabilization is in this shot. So we are getting the lens flare and light flickering, all those things, but this tool is doing pretty good job to stabilize this footage. And you can change the setting here, like the smoothing and all those things, but make sure when you change all those things, I think you have to analyze again, or you can clear analyze and do the analyze thing again. Now we remove the camera shake. So we have that data, so we can use those data to add a camera shake to another footage or somewhere else. So in this one, you can see I did the same thing on this footage. I removed the camera shake in this one, you can see, and use the steadiness here to remove that camera shake. Now you can see it's pretty smooth. We have a data here, right? So data is in this corner pin, and in this tool you can see there is one option is invert. What you can do, you can just copy paste this one, and let me take a checkerboard just to show you the point. You can apply this directly here, and instead of doing a stabilization, what you can do, you can just invert this one, and you can remove the scaling also, so it will maintain the scaling, otherwise it will do the scaling. So we need to remove the scaling, and you can invert this one. So now basically we are adding this footage camera shake into this checkerboard. So you can use this tool this way also. You can add a camera shake, or if you don't want to add directly, or if you want to store this data somewhere, what you can do, you can take one UV map. You just need to download Nuke Survival Toolkit, then you have this tool. Plug this one here, and you can view it here. So obviously, you get drag bar. So there is a overscan here. Just increase the amount to, and it will fill this area. Then we can use a crop here to remove the extra pixel, and then you can render this thing. Now this thing is moving. Now we have that camera shake baked in this ST map. We can call ST map or UV map. They are same, just a different name. What you can do, you can use that ST map transform, and then you can apply this to our checkerboard, or you can apply this to on any other plate and just select this to RGB. And now we have that exact camera shake what we have in this clip, we are applied on this checkerboard. So this is another way you can use this tool, and I found this is pretty good. You can extract any camera shake from the plate, and you can use this on your CG render or whatever, and it will give you pretty natural result because you extracted from the actual plate. That's how you can use this one. Now you can see it's shaking like we have in this example here. This is pretty cool way to do that. You can store many ways, so I'm just showing you the estimate because it's a pretty good way to store any transformation data. So that's why I show you this estimap method. That's how you can use this tool. I mean, I'm not going very deep inside tool. You can play around with the settings. We have filtering and corner pinning. As I said, you can just copy paste this one into separate corner pin. If you press about button, it will show you some information about the tool. Just give it a try, it's pretty good. And so I found to, you know, share with you about this tool. So we have a stabilization in Nuke, just like the warp stabilization. So definitely give a try. Let me know in the comment what you think about this tool, and thank you for watching. We will see you in a very next one. Have a great day.